Highland Mint. Minted memories that last a lifetime. Before a coin can be made, a sculpt of the image must first be created. The Highland Mint's artists painstakingly sculpt every detail by hand in soft clay. The diameter of the sculpt is 9 times the size of the coin that is going to be made. This allows every detail, no matter how small, to be captured. Once the artist is finished capturing the details in clay, a plaster mold is then cast from the original's clay sculpt. It is in the plaster that the artist goes back over every detail, making sure that the artwork is complete and true to form. From there, a rubber sculpt and then a negative image is poured in epoxy. This will eventually be used to cut the die. Before the die can be cut, a tool maker must create a cutter with the proper angles that will be used in the process of cutting a die. The negative epoxy is then mounted on a reducing machine that cuts the image into a soft steel die. The machine starts in the center of the sculpt and works its way to the edge. This process takes anywhere from 24 to 48 hours depending on the size of the coin that is going to be struck. Once the image is cut into a steel die, it must be examined under a microscope to prepare the surface for the stamping of a coin. Before the die can be used, the steel needs to be hardened and then polished to a brilliant finish. As part of the process, 0.999 fine silver must be converted from 1,000 ounce bars and grain to the exact size and weight of the finished coin. The bars and grain are weighed and then loaded into the blast furnace. 10,000 ounces of silver are melted each time. The silver is heated to over 1,800 degrees, where it turns to liquid. Heat-resistant asbestos suits must be worn for protection against the intense heat. A smaller crucible is superheated to over 2,000 degrees. The pure liquid silver is then poured into a smaller container, where it is then able to be poured into billet molds. The silver rapidly cools and hardens. It is then removed from the molds and quenched in water to further cool it off so it is able to be handled. The silver is constantly being weighed and inspected throughout the process. The pure silver billets are reheated to over 1,000 degrees. The billets are then placed in an extruder. Using hydraulic pressure of over 1,000 pounds per square inch, the silver is extruded into strips. The strips are left to cool and cut so as to make handling easier. The strips are then rolled to the exact thickness needed. From there, they are blanked out to the shape and size of the required coin. In addition to precious metals that the Highland Mint also processes copper, brass, and nickel. The material is blanked out to the required size before cleaning and striking. Each blank is then weighed to ensure the proper weight. Before the blank can be used to make a coin, it must be polished. A soap and water solution is used. The coins are placed in a burnisher where perfectly round ball bearings vibrate and are used to polish the coins to a mirror finish. Using centrifugal force and hot air, the coins are dried and are ready to be stamped. The polished blanks are then loaded into a coining press. They are then automatically fed into the machine. The machine holds a top and bottom die, and the blanks are placed in the middle. This way, both the front and back of the coin are struck at the same time. Depending on the quality, often coins are double or triple stamped. The finished coins are then weighed again. The Highland Mint's wide variety of presses, second to none in the industry, gives them the ability to strike any dimension or thickness. Various forms of packaging are used, from hard plastic capsules to soft plastic flip pouches. Another option is individually numbering each coin to enhance its collectability. The serial number can be placed on the back or side of the coin. In addition to its minting operation, the mint also offers framing and acrylic displays, again, all done in-house. A large inventory of molding is on hand, where it is cut and joined to produce quality frames of all sizes. In addition, the Highland Mint have the latest in computerized matte cutters and laser engravers that give them complete control of any project from start to finish. The Highland Mint is continuously investing in equipment and technology to keep them at the forefront of the minting industry. The Highland Mint is a full-service mint that was established in the early 1980s with state-of-the-art facilities housed in a 45,000 square foot building in Melbourne, Florida. The Highland Mint is a true American company. Not only are all of its products manufactured in the U.S., but the raw materials used are also American-made. The Highland Mint currently holds licenses with Major League Baseball, the National Football League, the National Basketball Association, the National Hockey League, and their respective players' associations. In addition, they also have licenses from over 30 colleges. All the Highland Mint products are created with the finest craftsmanship possible. From sculpting of the dyes, melting of silver, manufacturing frames, acrylic displays, and various forms of packaging, it is all done in-house. The Highland Mint has evolved over the years from a small mint to one of the largest in the United States. Its unique in-house abilities, latest equipment, and highly trained staff enable them to complete any job, no matter how big or small, complex or simple, on time and within your budget. The Highland Mint. Minted memories that last a lifetime.